Hello, Mojo from ThreeChordGuitar.com, and tonight we're looking at a song that's been a staple in classic rock for a long time, and it's called Dust in the Wind. It's a good finger-picking song, although you can also do it with straight chords, and well, in this video we'll look at both ways, because what the heck. Alright, Kansas was the band, if memory serves, that made that song, and or wrote that song, or played that song, or recorded that song, and just about everybody else has been covering it ever since. Alright, so it starts in a C, so to you move a little bit here so you have a better vision of what my fingers are doing. That's a C chord. If you have any questions about the chords you're going to be doing right now, we have some chord charts on the website available for free download, and we also have some videos, also free, that will show you how to make any chord that we're going to be looking at in this video and probably in others as well. Alright, so we start with a C, then we'll go to a G, and then to an A minor. Now obviously the C and the A minor are very close. Okay? So it goes, close my eyes, just for a moment and the moment's gone. What you hear here is I'm staying in an A minor, trying to put my guitar in a better position here. Staying in an A minor, and then I do a hammer-on pull-off type of thing with my pinky on the third fret of the high E string. See, pinky on, pinky off, regular A minor with a pinky. Okay, so close my eyes, G, just for a moment and the moment's gone. Back to an A minor, and then back to a C. Sleep, sleep. I don't even know if that's the right lyrics, but it doesn't matter. In the ground, those we refuse to see. Then we'll go to a G. Dust in the wind. Back to an A minor. G. All we have is dust in the wind. Back an A minor. C. G. A minor. Back to the chorus, G. Dust in the wind, A minor. G, we are as dust in the wind, A minor. And that, my friends, is the whole song. In terms of the finger picking, as promised, I'm going to place my guitar in a different position here so you can have a better look at my right hand, which means that you won't see my left hand anymore or half my face, but that's the good news. The chords are not going to change, and I may announce them as we go along or I may not, depending on whether I think about it or not. But basically refer yourself to the part we just did together and you'll have the chords right. So we start with a C, and as always, my thumb is going to be in the business of hitting the bass, which in this case would be the A string, which in the context of a C chord will be fretted by my ring finger at the third fret. So it's actually a pattern with a couple of times. At real speed it goes like this. at a slower speed, thumb, so the middle finger will hit the fifth string, the index will hit the G string, and the middle finger will be back up to hit the high E, if I fretted correctly with my left hand over here. So in other words, it goes from top to bottom, A between two being 2 and high E being 6, 2, 5, 4, 6, 2, oops, 2, 5, 4, 6. In terms of fingers involved, we have thumb, middle, index, middle. Then we go back to the index hitting the fifth string, and the middle finger hitting the fourth, and then we go to a G, and so I have to move my thumb from the A string to the low E just so that I can still hit the bass note. My other fingers do the same stuff they've been doing. So we end up with 1, 5, 4, 6, 1, 5, 4, 6, so 2, 5, 4, 6, 1, 5, 4, 6. Go to an A minor, so the thumb is back on the A string, so to do that little, remember how in the A minor we added the pinky on the third fret of the high E string, so how do we do that? What we do is we hit with the Johnny Cash, excuse my graphic display here, the Johnny Cash finger on the picking hand hits the high E, then, which is fretted, the high E string is fretted by the pinky on the left hand at the third fret. And then the index finger will hit consecutively the B and G string. So middle, index, index, and then middle again, but note that this time the pinky is off when we're in a regular A minor chord. So that gives us middle finger, index, index, middle, index, index, middle, index, index, middle, index, index. All right, this should give you enough to have some fun and to feel, to get a good feel for the pattern in terms of finger picking. The rest of it is just playing it and enjoying it. So practice. If you have any questions, you know where to find me. Don't hesitate. Never a bother. We have a forum at ThreeChordGuitar.com, and I hope to see you there soon. Take good care, and be well.